晚上好，中新社记者提问。据报道，美国20号在安理会再次独家否决阿尔及利亚起草的关于呼吁立即在加沙地带实行人道主义停火的决议草案，这是美国第三次否决与加沙冲突有关的决议草案。请问中方对此有何评论？谢谢。
中国常驻联合国代表已经在表决后的解释性发言中全面阐述了中方立场。当前巴以冲突仍在延宕，加沙人道局势极其严峻，地区和平稳定遭到严重冲击，安理会必须尽快采取行动推动停火止战，这是不容推辞的道德义务，是必须承担的法律责任，也是履行联合国宪章的政治要求。阿尔及利亚代表阿拉伯国家提出决议草案，要求在加沙立即实现停火，立即释放全部人质，保障人道物资准入，反对强制迁移，这是形势的紧迫需要，也是基于人道最起码的要求，得到了安理会绝大多数成员的支持，中国投了赞成票。美国再次独家否决，把加沙局势推到了更加危险的境地，包括中方在内有关各方均对此表示强烈失望和不满。我们将继续同国际社会各方一道，推动安理会采取进一步负责任、有意义的行动，为早日平息加沙战火、缓解人道局势、推动落实两国方案、实现中东地区长治久安做出不懈努力。
谢谢发言人。本地青年报记者提问。昨天世界银行宣布任命中国进出口银行副行长张文才担任世行常务副行长兼首席行政官，请问中方对此有何评论？谢谢。
我们对世行这一任命表示欢迎。中国是世界上最大的发展中国家，世行是全球最大的多边开发机构，过去40多年来，双方建立了紧密的发展伙伴关系，开展了富有成效的合作。中方支持世行通过改革强化发展宗旨和机构能力，帮助发展中国家实现可持续发展，并有效应对全球性挑战。我们期待与世行继续深化合作，为全球减贫与发展事业做出积极贡献。
Thank you. Question from Reuters. Is China sending any representative to attend the G20 meeting of foreign ministers in Brazil that starts today, Wednesday? Is Minister Wang Yi attending? If not, why not? And will China be represented at all? Thank you.
王毅外长因为日程安排的原因难以出席此次会议，委派马昭旭副部长代表中方出席。
A question from NHK. Tan Jianqi, a daughter of Chinese human rights activist Tan Jitian, passed away due to pneumonia in Tokyo yesterday.The Chinese authorities has prohibited him from leaving China to see her daughter, to his daughter, citing national security concerns. What is China's take on this matter?
我不了解你提到的有关情况。
Good afternoon. A question from AFP. Yang Jun, the Chinese-born Australian citizen with handing a suspended death sentence for espionage, will not appeal, according to his family. They say that his health has deteriorated and he no longer has the strength to fight the charges. Does China provide medical assistance to him? And what's Yang Jun's health status?
关于你提到的这个案件，我记得我的同事此前已经介绍过有关情况。我可以告诉你的是，中国是法治国家，中国的司法机关会依法的处理有关的案件，也会继续依法保护当事人的各项合法权益。
Yes, one more question from Reuters, also related to the G20 meeting. Russia has objected to putting Ukraine on the meeting agenda. Would China agree to discussions on Ukraine at the G20 meeting? Thank you.
二十国集团是国际经济合作的主要论坛，不是解决地缘政治和安全问题的平台。这是二十国集团的共识。我们期待此次外长会有助于推动各方加强团结合作，为促进世界经济增长和全球发展做出积极贡献。
Hi, question from Bloomberg.
Bloomberg has reported that the U.S. has told its allies that Russia could deploy a nuclear weapon into space as early as this year. The people said that Russia is developing a space-based capability to knock out satellites using a nuclear weapon. As China has urged the international community to avoid the use of nuclear weapons in the past, we wondered if the foreign ministry had any comments on this report. Thank you.
你提到俄罗斯可能在太空部署核武器的事情呢，我注意到俄方已经做出了回应。俄方强调俄罗斯一贯反对在太空部署核武器，并且呼吁遵守所有的现有协议。那么至于中方，我们在有关问题上的政策立场是一贯，也是非常明确的。如果没有其他问题的话，今天的记者会到此结束，谢谢大家。